All right, grab that baseball.
Grab it.
There it is. It popped off. All right, and we back for the second game of the morning. We got Tri-Village Patriots in the all red and with the blue trim. And we have them going against the Margaretta Polar Bears. The Polar Bears are in white with green trim. So this should be a good battle of a showdown as well. About to get the tip off. Getting ready for the national anthem, I'm assuming. Or to start lineup, sorry.
And here are these words from a speech on March 28, 1968, when Dr. King talked about America's need to establish priorities.
It is time to reorder our national priorities. All those who now speak of goodwill and who praise the work of such.
The head coach for Tri-Village Patriots is Brad Gray. He's coaching up against Margaretta Polar Bears, Lady Polar Bears, with Eric Ken Durfer.
Thank you. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to game number two of the 2020 Classic in the Country Challenge, featuring the team on the floor, the Tri-Village High School.
Okay, so we just found out that Tri-Village is going to be the away team. And the home team is going to be the
Cross County Conference, and as a current 15-0, they are last year's Tri-C Conference champions and Division IV regional semifinalists with a 24-2 record, and are currently ranked 6th in the state AP poll. Meanwhile, Margaretta is a member of the Sandusky Bay Conference, and as a current 13-0, they are last year's Division III.
This is going to be a good game, ladies and gentlemen.
Ranked number 2 in the state AP poll.
The Polar Bears are ranked number 2 in the state poll, and Tri-Village is ranked
ladies
number 6.
Let's see the starting lineup for both teams, starting
so
with
now
the
we're
going
to go to the start. Coming out first.
Starting at guard, the Patriots, a 5'6 freshman, number 4, Bradley Sagan. At 4, a 6'2 sophomore, number 20, Megan Downing. Starting at guard, a 5'4 senior, number 24, Andy Pietri. At guard, a 5'7 senior, number 30, Lisa Seiler. And at center, a 6'1 senior, number 33, Maddie Downing. The Patriots are led by assistant coach Lady DeWater.
Okay, the Patriots have Riley as a point guard. Starting as a freshman on varsity.
Now ladies and gentlemen, let's get the starting lineup for the Polar Bears.
And we're coming to you all the way live with Creative Media. Live with the classic in the country. Basketball classic.
Taylor Molson. At guard, a 5'10 freshman, number 10, Kylie Leibacher. At guard, a 5'8 senior commit to Tiffin, number 14, Shaden Moore. And at guard, a 5'11 sophomore, number 20, Devin Eisenhower. The Polar Bears are led by assistant coaches Ray Neal, Dan Edberg, Gary Bailey, Jake Wagner, Jessica Meyer.
All right, it's time to jump it up.
Third season with the Polar Bears, head coach Eric Kokendorfer. Ladies and gentlemen, we hope you enjoy your experience this weekend in the country. Now it's time for some basketball.
And here comes the jump ball. Looks like the Patriots are going to start off with it. Looks like they're just going to swing it. Oh, good steal. Couldn't run it down, but good intensity. And that is by Taylor Molson. Okay. Patriots, Lady Patriots started all the way. Swing it inside and it's stalled by the Polar Bears. Lady Polar Bears are pushing up the court. Good no look pass for a two shot. And it's good.
Taylor Molson.
And that's Taylor Molson with 2 points already to start the game off. Corner. Good way to go inside. Nice miss, but with the put back. And I think that's the Patriots 33. To the line, that's Maddie Downing. Little off, right there on the free throw. Spots up for the second free throw. Second free throw is off as well. Polar Bears are pushing back up the court. Nice little dime pass. Swung it back out. Off on the shoe of the Lady Patriots. The Lady Polar Bear have it to start it. 7 minutes and 8 seconds in the first quarter. She spots out, shoots a three. Good rebound. And in foul trouble.
Megan Downing, that's her first personal team's first.
Going to the line for the Polar Bears is Kaylee. She hits the first.
Substitution for the Patriots. Number 14, Morgan Hunt.
Freshman misses the second shot. It's 3-0 on the clock. Patriots are penetrating to the hole. Now it looks like she's trapped in a corner. Yep. And the Polar Bears, a nice crossover all the way. And that's Taylor Molson. And she's a senior. And just like that, quick timeout by Bryce. He has to get them together before this gets out of hand. We already seen a blowout in the first game. So now we're looking at 5-0.
Light up the West with savings on LED bulbs from APOhioplace.com.
Like the Patriots have got themselves back together. And the Lady Polar Bears are taking the court as well. Looks like they're going to start off in a press. There it is. And they have broke the press so far. Andy's going to set up the offense. Dribble drive by number 30. Nice pass. Quick jumper for two. And that is by Jaden Moore. She's a senior, 5'8". Oh, good steal. Lady Polar Bears call a timeout as they're going to get the possession after the steal.
30-second timeout.
7-0 with 6 minutes left in the first quarter. Well, it looks like we're back to action after that quick 30-second timeout. Keep in mind, you are with Creative Media Live. I am Eric Patterson calling all the girls' games tonight. We will be having interviews, player of the game as well. Okay, Lady Polar Bears. Looks like that was almost a steal by the Patriots. And for a three. Okay, got a foul down low. It's going to Patriots ball.
Patriots
number 23 is coming in the game, and that's Trisha Porter, 5'8 seniors. Trisha Porter is running the point guard. Passes to Riley. Go inside. Nice down low to Maddie Downing. We're looking at 7-2. Another 3-point shot. It's off. Number 14. It's D and up number 10. Another over the back. With a nice putback by the Lady Polar Bears. Devin Eisenhower. She's a sophomore. Okay, there's a turnover. Looks like the Lady Polar Bears got it. Now the Patriots got it back. Good pass. Patiently waiting the Patriots. She didn't see anything open. Swing the ball. 4-3. Good steal. Oh, and a foul. Looks like Morgan Hunt is going to go to the line.
Polar Bears fouls on number 20. Devin Eisenhower, her second, team
third. Good free throw shot. Makes the score 3-9.
JL Keller.
Another free throw is good. We're looking at the score as 9-5 with 4:30 left in the first quarter. Polar Bears bring the ball up, slow it up. Good swing shot. And there it is. And that's from number one, Jaylee Keller, the freshman. Okay, there's a steal. And another 2 points. And just like that. Oh, she traveled. That's going to be a turnover by the Patriots. Just like that. 13-4. Bringing up the ball for the Lady Polar Bears. Number 4, Taylor Lawson. Okay, looks like they're running the weave for pop out three. Nice ball rotation. Nelson goes to the hole. Gets it. Goes over to the Patriots. Lady Patriots dribble up hard. Find him in the corner. She takes her time. Swing it. And bang, bang. Oh, and a good follow by the Patriots. Another jump shot. And that's a little off the mark. And we got a foul on the polar bear. Lady Polar Bears number three. And Anna Schaefer. We have a substitute.
For the Patriots, number four, Riley Sagister. And substitution for the Polar Bears, number 23, Cassidy Cheek.
Lady Patriots are setting up their offense. Penetrate straight through the hole, and she's fouled. And that foul is going to be on...
Polar Bears fouls on number 23, Cassidy.
Okay, that's going to be on Cassidy. Good pass, swing out for a three. And that is off the mark. And with the nice putback, missed two layups. Lady Polar Bears go all the way straight to the hole and draw the foul.
Serve first personal, team second.
Off the mark. Lady Patriots are getting the ball up their court. Setting up their offense. Working the ball inside out, trying to beat the 2-3. And the zone worked in the behalf of the Polar Bears. And the freshman. Good block. Lady Patriots are in transition. A little too much on that. It's going to go to Lady Polar Bears' way.
Polar Bears substitution, number 34, Cassidy Smith-Fields, as well as number 3, Eliana Schaefer.
Okay, the freshman, J.L. Keller, brings the ball up the court. Looks down low, kick out. Looks like they're in a 1-3-1, and it works off for the Lady Patriots. As Trish Porter brings the ball up, drops it inside. Little two-man game down low. And a three, little off the mark. And that was Riley who shot that.
Patriots substitution.
We're at 50 seconds, point three, left in the first quarter. As the Margaretta Lady Polar Bears are leading 13 against Tri-Village Patriots.
Substitute
Polar Bears, number 23,
Cassidy Cheek.
Oh, those are alley-oop. Ah, good power dribble, and she got it to go in, and that's number 14, Morgan Hunt.
Morgan Hunt.
Lady Polar Bears are trying to get something before the end of the quarter. 14 seconds left. Nice win move and cuts through. And that's good. Elion Schaefer. Buzzer shot. He said, are they going to get points? Did they come? Doesn't look like they're going to give it to her.
Time to get prizes from AEP Ohio. So let's hear it over here. Do you guys want prizes? Yeah, you want a prize. You want a prize.
Yeah, they did give it to her. So she did get her point. So she did get that. So the score is 15-9 going into the second quarter. Again, we had a whole team, Margaretta, Polar Bear, Lady Polar Bears.
This side wins.
As they are winning 15 to Tri-Village Patriots.
Thank you to AEP Ohio's Energy Efficiency Program. Two laps, be proud. We will see you at halftime.
Well, it looks like we're about to start the second quarter. 15-9 again with the Lady Polar Bears leading. We just missed a heck of a buzzer beater. Okay, the Lady Polar Bears start off the second quarter with the ball. Cross court pass and the Patriots intercept it. Lady Patriots look like they're trying to get it down low. Got it right at the free throw. I've got a kickball on the Lady Polar Bears, number 14.
Substitution for the Patriots.
Jalen Moore.
Maddie Downing.
Lady Patriots get the inbound in. Looks like it's going to be a turnover for the Polar Bears, and that's a foul on number four, Riley.
Fouls on number four, Riley Sagister. That's their first personal team start. Into the game for the Polar Bears, number 20, Devin Eisenhower.
And that's her first. We still stand at 15-9, 7-12 on the clock. Lady Polar Bears with the lead. Bang, bang, for three. And that is Eliana Schaefer. She's got 7 points. She's leading the team. Okay, the Patriots got a wide open three as well. Off the mark, rebound by the Lady Polar Bear. Look like Kaylee. Good pick. She goes all the way to the hole again.
Eliana Schaefer.
Eliana Schaefer with 9 points in the second quarter with the lead 20-9 versus the Tri-Village Patriots. Patriots are just exposing each pass that they have. Eliana's like, I'm taking it. Good pass. Look to go down low. And Eliana again.
Eliana Schaefer.
12 points.
Eliana.
Elion Schaefer, the junior, is hot right now with 12 points as Margaretta Polar Bears are leading with 5 minutes and 43 seconds left in the clock. They're leading 23-9 against the Tri-Village Patriots. So we want to thank you for joining us at the Classic in the Country. You are with Creative Media Live, and that's what we're doing, bringing it to y'all all the way live, bringing it to you 100. I just can't get over Elion. She is balling. Elion is a 5'6 junior. Pure shooter. Pure slasher. She's getting anything that she wants done right now. As the Lady Polar Bear takes the court, waiting on the away team, the Tri-Village Patriots. All righty. We are back in the second quarter with 5:40 left. Tri-Village is bringing the ball up to court. It looks like Annie running the offense. Good move. Off. Oh, they just run the floor so good. She got caught from behind. Tri-Village looking to try to get some points on the board. Slows the ball up, get into the offense. Look like they're trying to work it inside. Now they pop out for three. Off the mark. Looks like the Lady Polar Bears are going to push it up the court real quick. And guess who else but no other? Eliana. Ball stays. All right. Lady Polar Bears set it up. Swing. Eliana again. She's off the mark. Rebound by Tri-Village. Patriots are pushing up court. They have numbers. Slow it up. Looks like Annie's going to run a point right now. Gets it to Lisa. Okay, slash into the hole. Tri-Village. Another three. And that's off the mark. And it looks like Taylor Mawson gives it up for Eliana, who misses the layup, who gets fouled as Mawson with the follow-up. She's also a 5'6", but she's a senior. Four work too good together. They're great combination guards. Good free throw.
Substitutions for the Patriots. Number 20, Megan Downing, and number 23, Trissa Porter.
3 minutes and 58 seconds in the second quarter. And we're looking at Margaretta Polar Bears leading 24-9. The Patriots just get the rebound and turnover. Bringing up the court. Great slash to the hole. And that's a good point by Riley Slicer. She's a freshman, 5'6". Eliana is taking her time getting up the court, seeing what she sees. Trying to set the offense up, drops it down. Swing out, nice shot. Nice shot, number 14, Jay Moore. That's the senior. Timeout. Tri-Village, I was wondering if he's going to call it or not.
Patriots.
A little frustration by Coach Brad. Well, I will tell you, Margaretta polar bears are looking very active. Great ball movement, great transition basketball as they lead 26-11 with 3:02 left in the second quarter. Looks like our still our high score for the first half right now. It has to be Eliana Schaefer. The junior is showing her worth out there today. And if you're wondering, the polar bears are in the all green and white, and the Tri-Village Patriots are in the red with the blue trim. All right, we're back into action. Nice little ball movement. Nice little swing pass to the corner. Little penetration, looks like she stepped out of bounds. That's gonna be a turnover on Riley.
Substitution for the polar bears, number one, Gerald Keller. And substitutions for the Patriots, number 24.
Got a little Andy substitution Patriot, going on
number
here.
Number 30, this is Silo.
Get up the court. Gets it back to Eliana, who's running a point guard. And she's getting it inside. Back out. Lady Polar Bears are taking their time, not rushing anything, just running right through the offense. Great pass. Taylor tries to take it up, and she, it looked like a block to me, but the ref called a foul. So back to the line is Taylor Mawson.
That's her first personal,
she's shooting two. First one up and good. And she has 6 points on the night right now. Second shot up, and that's off the mark a little bit. The Patriots are pushing the ball up. Riley controls the offense, swings it out to Andy. Oh, good steal from, nope. Tri-Village shoots a three. Off the mark. We still have a good one here. It's 27-11 with a minute 47 left in the second quarter. Polar Bears are making a substitution. Getting out Keller. Give her a breather. All right, looks like a little bit of a press. Eliana stops, gets it to Taylor. Taylor crossover, slow the ball back up. Okay. Oh, she traveled. And that was a good move. Jaden Moore, that was a good move, girl. Just gotta watch your feet. All right, back in the game for the Polar Bears is Jaylee Keller. Just a little quick breather as the Patriots bring the ball up the court. Tried to go inside. They do keep possession. Going back in the corner for three. And that's a little bit off the mark as well. Kaylee Leibar is bringing the ball up, getting it to Eliana. Just playing a weave. 33 seconds left on the clock. Looks like they're going to try to hold off for the last shot with the lead at 27-11. And she's not shy at all. She's going to get hers. Ah, and that's a foul on the Polar Bears, so we're going the other way of Margaretta. Looks like the Patriots are going to have the last possession with 17 seconds and 17.8 seconds on the clock. Patriots bring the ball up pretty quick. 10 seconds left. Nice little jump shot, and that shot is off. Three-pointer at the buzzer. 1 second left, and that was almost a good one by Taylor Monson. And we go into halftime 27-11.
All right, let's give it up for these teams. Great work, ladies. Okay, so for this halftime,
and at the half, we will get back with you. You are watching today on Creative Media Live. We are having a good day. This is game two between Tri-Village Patriots and the Margaretta Polar Bears. And I would have to say the Lady Polar Bears came to play today.
Give it up for this gentleman. Come on over here, high five. High five.
pause or turn.
It might be.
So just let it play and just start.
Same thing, ask her to push on me.
All right, and we're back, getting ready to start the third quarter. We got Tri-Village Patriots, the guests, wearing the red with the blue and white trim. They have 11 points, and the Tri-Village Patriots have to get back into this game because the Lady Polar Bears of Margaretta have no remorse. They're trying to get this game over with as they lead 27-11. We're going to start off the third quarter with Tri-Village with the ball. Okay, it looks like the energy's picked up for Tri-Village. Margaretta playing good defense. And a foul on number 14. That's going to be Jaden Moore.
Polar Bears fouls on number 10, Kylie Blybacher.
Excuse me, that would be number 10, Kylie.
First.
The 5'10 freshman. First free throw is no good for Tri-Village Patriots. Spots up for the second free throw, and that one's good. Okay, it looks like they're going to try a press to get back in this game. Right in the corner. Timeout.
Timeout, Polar Bears.
By Coach Eric. Wants to talk it over. He's seen the press. Didn't make him feel too comfortable with the ball in the corner. So with 7:31 in the third quarter, the Lady Polar Bears take their first second half timeout. And this is game two of the classic in the country. We're in Berlin, Ohio. Okay, with the possession arrow going away of the Polar Bears, they come out with a press breaker. They get it right out to Elian. Elian looks down court, number 20, swing it over in the corner, nice little stop and pop, and there it is.
Taylor Mawson.
She has 8 points. Tri-Village looked kind of confused on getting their offense together. Pass right into the left corner. Go back over to the left corner. Try to get it down low. Looks like that will be a steal. Another steal comes back Tri-Village way. The Lady Patriots turn it right back over to the Lady Polar Bears. A nice move. Ladies are on the floor. Good job. Eliana for three. And that's a bang bang.
Eliana,
she leads with 15 points. Eliana came to play today. All right. Looks like they got a 3-2 zone going. Leaves open a 3-point shooter with a miss. Moore with the rebound. Moore going, look like she's going all the way. Kick out pass. Looks like they're just going to find Eliana again. Eliana kicks it back out. Let them reset the offense for the Lady Polar Bears. Okay. That's going to stay the possession right here. Well, Tri-Village Patriots have picked up the defense and the urgency. just not getting no points up on the board right now. Ball goes out to Kaylee. Kaylee gets it back out to Eliana. Eliana Schaefer is having a great game today as she crossover dribbles. Okay, that's going to be a foul on Kaylee, the freshman, 5'10".
Polar Bears fouls on number 10, Kylie Leibacher. That's her second personal, team second.
Tri-Village comes down. Looking to get something on the board. They go down low for an easy layup. And that was by number 14, Morgan Hunt. Okay, here she goes. Good pass. Nice stop and pop. Low off. Rebound by Tri-Village. Lady Patriots are looking to come down and score again. Turnover. Jada Moore kicks it up to Kaylee. Kaylee makes the two. We're looking at 5 minutes left in the third quarter. 34-14, 20-point lead. Another steal. All the way. Polar Bears. Oh, missed layup. He's going to stay here with the foul on the rebound.
Patriots foul is on number 20, Megan Downing. That's her second personal, team's first.
Coming out the game is Taylor Mawson.
J.L. Keller. And into the game for the Patriots, number 23, Trista Porter.
I'm pretty sure she's going to get back in the game. She's just getting a quick rest. Polar Bear swing the ball over to Jaden Moore. Pull it back out. Letting their point guard run the show, the freshman. Oh, nice move inside. Get her own rebound. And Tri-Village. Okay. Tri-Village showing a little aggressiveness on the rebound.
Polar Bears fouls on number three, Eliana Schaefer.
And that foul will be on Eliana Schaefer.
Personal.
That's her second.
Into the game for the Polar Bears, number 23, Cassidy Cheek.
Good inside presence. By the Patriots. With the zone. Polar Bears break the zone. Kick out. And that's going to stay here. Great defense stopping possession to the hole.
Substitution for the Polar Bears. Number 4, Taylor Molson. And number 14, Jade Moore.
Schaefer for three, a little off the mark. Oh, outlet pass went out of bounds. It's going to go back to the Polar Bears. Lady Polar Bears are very, very fortunate in getting that one back. Substitution, late substitution.
Substitution for the Patriots.
We're sitting at 34-16 with the home team, the Polar Bears. Good jab step. Stepped out of line. We're going to go back to Tri-Valley. Again, the Lady Polar Bears lead 34-16 with 3:35 left in the third quarter. As Tri-Village Lady Patriots try to get back in the game, and there's a three, and that's nothing but net.
Riley Sager for three.
From Riley, the freshman. There's the combination again. Great inside, good pass. Tri-Village.
Riley Downing.
The Lady Polar Bears can't let Tri-Village get back in this game.
Patriot fouls on number 20, Megan Downing. That's her third personal, team second.
As the possession arrow states here with the Lady Polar Bears, we're standing at 36-21.
Andy Beatrice. Substitution for the Polar Bears, number 10, Kylie Leibacher.
A little bit of substitution going on. All right, the ref is ready. Ah, little high pass, he's able to control it. And that's more. The freshman, Jaylee Keller, handling the ball. There's the weave again, going inside. Nice little stop and pop by number 14, Jaylen Moore. Jaylen Moore has 8 points. Tri-Village is looking to get down low, but that's a steal. Guess by who? Miss Moore. Ah, tied up. Looks like it's going to stay here, the possession arrow with the Lady Polar Bears. We're sitting at a minute and 54 seconds left in the third quarter. Nice little kick out to Moore. Or, I'm sorry, Mawson, excuse me, Morris, 14. Miss Keller passes over. Looks like they're just going to run a little bit of clock. And then she's going to drive all the way to the hole and kick out. Two more. Moore kicks it out. And it looks like Tri-Village gets the rebound. Pushing up court is number 4, Rayleigh. Nice little stop and pop. Shots a little off. And that's going to be a foul. Tri-Village come out with the press. Looks like that's no problem for the Polar Bears. And they're going to call a charge. I don't know how that was a charge on Eliana, but if that's the ref's call, Tri-Village is going the opposite way. A minute left in the quarter. We're sitting at 38-21. Comes straight down the middle with a jumper, and that's good for number 24, Andy. Margaretta looks to hold off again. Good pass. They're just gonna work a little bit of this clock, try to get them in foul trouble, and they did. And that's going to be foul on number 33, Ultra Village, Maddie Downing.
That's her first personal.
With her first, she comes out the game. Twenty-five seconds left on the clock. As Eliana kicks it out. Now we get it all the way back up to the freshman. JL, number 14, Moore with the missed layup. Okay, and we get a foul with 1 second left. That foul is going to be on number 10, Kaylee.
That's her third personal.
She's sitting with 3 fouls. Number 14, Morgan Hunt.
Number 33, Maddie Downing. And in the game for the Polar Bears, number 34.
With one free throw down. She's set for a second free throw. And it's good. Score is 25-38. And that's the end of the third quarter going into the fourth.
Let's give it up to these ladies. Woo! All right, are you guys ready for your competition? Your AEP Ohio prizes? All right, we're going to do the wave. All right, so we will start at the ends here.
You want me to just have practice?
Down and back. All right, and the side to get back the fastest wins. All right.
Because she said she was keeping track and make sure.
It's 4
You working. You think it's still the first game. In the fourth quarter, we're looking at 44-28. Margaretta Polar Bears, Lady Polar Bears are leading. Nice swing pass, dribble penetration to the hole with the foul. The Patriots will be going to the hole.
Polar Bear fouls on number 20, Devin Eisenhower. That's her third personal.
That's on Devin Eisenhower, as you hear in the background. That will be her third. The score now is 29-44. She spots up for her second free throw. And that's good. 14-point lead for the Polar Bears. Good pass. Good pass right back for an easy two. And that's Jayna Moore with 10 points. Side pop and shot and good by number 30, Lisa Seiler. Eliana pushes up the court. Nice little pop. Troy Vellage on a fast break, put back. Got another rebound, Tri-Village. Put back off. Another steal, Tri-Village gets it back. Little confusion there, it was going back and forth for a while. Tri-Village regains and shoots another three, and she slashes it, bang, bang. Polar Bears take a timeout. We have 4:43 left in the fourth quarter. As Coach Eric calls the timeout to regroup his girls for the rest of the game.
Switch to Energy Star certified LED bulbs and get instant in-store discounts. Learn more at aepohio.com/save.
So once again, guys, we're at the Classic in the country. This is coming to you from Creative Media Live. I'm Eric Patterson. We got a wonderful crew working with us today. We're all over the place in Berlin, Ohio, where the crowds are getting bigger and bigger, and we'll be here all day. So get used to my voice, because we're going to be getting used to calling these games. We got some good ones coming up. We're only on game two. All right, we're coming out of the timeout. Again, it's 4:43 left on the clock. The home team is the Margaretta Lady Polar Bears, who are leading the Tri-Village Lady Patriots. Looks like another press is coming. They're going to try to break the press. Again, Elion with 19 points, taking her time. And she's a junior. moving screen on the Lady Polar Bears. Goes back. Tri Village. This is the time for Tri Village to get back in the game. We stand at 4:26 left in the fourth quarter. It's only a 10-point lead. If we can get that hot shooting again out of Lisa Sawyer. And it looks like that's what they're going to, but we got a kickball by Eliana. I'm pretty sure she's going to get it back. Whoop, they go to the opposite side for three. And they, just missed it. And the missed rebound goes to Tri-Village. Cross court, could have been fouled, was no call. Good block on the other end. Tri-Valley, and there's the foul. There's the foul on number 10, Haley. And that's her fourth. You're going to need her. Good free throw from Tron. Village Patriots cutting into that lead. And that was number 30, Lisa Sawyer. And we got a foul going the opposite way. And it looks like since they're in 1-1 with 8 fouls. Patriots foul is on Downey. Number 20.
That's her fourth personal, team's ninth.
Megan Downey, that's her fourth as well. Miss free throw. Going the opposite way, cut to the hoop. Miss layup, fights for it and gets a foul. And that's going to be on Andy. The sophomore, for a sophomore.
Number 24, Andy Beatrice. That's her third personal.
She's with 3 fouls.
The Polar Bears are now in the double bonus.
Now we're sending a double bonus, and if you guys don't know what double bonus means, that means they get 2 free throws automatically instead of just 1-1. First free throw up, and that's good. And that's a miss layup. Tri-Valley, but she gets it back, puts it up and miss. Tri-Valley gets, okay, they get fouled. And that foul was by Miss Moore.
Polar Bear fouls on number 14, Jane Moore.
And she had she has 4 fouls now. Even though the scoreboard says she has 3 fouls. Commentator just said 4. First free throw up. And it's good. Okay, 2 good free throws. 3:47 left. Elion gets the outlet pass out to 20. And she makes easy layup. Devin Eisenhower. There it is. Elion gets the ball back. Elion gets it, and that's a foul on number 4 on Riley, the freshman. 5
Patriots
sacks.
Fouls on number 4, Riley Sagaser. That's her second personal.
And she has 14 points, but 2 fouls. So going to the line is our leader. And she knocked down with ease. And that's Elion Schaefer, the junior. Elion shoots the second, and it's nothing but she has 21 points on the night. Tri Village comes down. Good pass inside. You got a kickball called by the ref. Tri-Village is doing anything they can to get back in this game. They're only down by 10 points with 3:14 left in the game. good backdoor pass and an easy, simple layup. Oh, underneath still, Tri-Village. And now another scoop layup by Morgan Hunt. Morgan Hunt, 14 points. That was a foul.
That's
her
fourth personal.
Going to the line is Taylor Mawson. Taylor's having a great solid game as well. She has 10 points. Shoots a free throw, nothing but net. Give her 11. She spots up for the second free throw. Shoots it. Good. Has 12 points as Tri-Village comes down, swinging the ball. They're looking for, definitely looking for the three, and there it is. Bang, bang. Bang, bang. With 17 points, Polar Bear look down low to attack. They kick it back out. Elion tries to fake her. There's nothing there. Lady Polar Bears trying to hold on and burn some of this clock off. Oh, that looked like that could have been a charge, ref. But guess who's shooting? Elion. Up. There's the steal. Tri-Village has momentum. It's 48-53 with 2 minutes left in the game. Turnover to Taylor. Taylor with the crossover. Carrying. Timeout called by the coach. Coach Eric. A little bit out of control, but we got a good one here, a good comeback. 53-48. Tri-Village is trailing. The Lady Patriots are fighting. Margaretta Polar Bears have to hang in there and keep their composure if they win this one out. Elion Schaefer with 21 points. And on the other end, we got Riley. She has 17, so it's a good game. Going back and forth for game two. People are waking up. We have a good one here. We will have an interview, ladies and gentlemen, with the player of the game after the game, before we go into game three. All right, Tri-Village is coming out there huddle first. These are looking to take over this game and come back and give a good fight. I'm just amazed at how they battle back out of that deficit that they had to the Lady Polar Bears. That Lady Patriots hanging in there. Just please stay out of foul trouble. Polar Bears inbound. She goes all the way to the far corner. Taylor Mawson crossing over, keeping her dribble. Elion with the bump. And it looks like she's going to go to the line and increase her points.
Patriots fouls on number four, Riley Sagaster. That's her third personal.
First shot up and a little off. Off the mark. Second shot up and good. Elion with 22 points. Minute left. And I'm going to let you guys go ahead and enjoy the rest of this game.
Correction, this is not fired, that's a fourth. Ladies and gentlemen, with a game high 24 points, congratulations to Eliana Schaefer.
I cannot believe this girl is a freshman, ladies and gentlemen. Freshman point guard, forward, she could do it all. This is, tell them your name.
I'm Riley.
LeBron James? Okay, who's your female girl, Paul? Who's your female? Okay, there we go.
Yeah.
Well, we appreciate it. You had a great game. I think you ended up with 22 points or 20 points.
I think it was 23.
Oh, excuse me, girl. But she did her thing today with 23 points. Only a freshman.